Standards, but then again, it is still summer. Either way, the AC is working just fine at US Bank Stadium in the Twin Cities. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store, as it'll be the Green Bay Packers taking on the Minnesota Vikings. 2 weeks have come and gone. It's off to week three, and we're underway on EA Sports. And no return here to start. It's a fair catch, and they will set up shop at the 25.
Ready.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. He finds his man complete. It's Ellis. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. 13 yards on the game's opening play.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations.
Devin Pirate.
A guy of his size can't really hide him.
Right in.
Drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. Romeo Doubs is intended receiver, and it's second down. You look at this defense for the Vikings. They come into this one ranked number 5 in the NFL against the run.
Most of their challenges have come in the passing game because against the run, they've been pretty
slow down those receivers before they get downfield.
Come on, come on.
Make a few more plays on the ball when it's in the air.
Second and 10.
Get up.
And he'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge, and that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
Here we go,
third,
here we go. Six the Eagle. 79 Bronco. Check out.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Able to find the open man. That's complete. There he goes, right side. Touchdown, Packers. Christian Watson, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Packers are on the board first here this afternoon. Anders Carlson now for the point after. And it's good to make it 7-0 Packers.
Makes the score Packers 7, Vikings nothing. Anders Carlson to kick off for the Packers.
Carlson back out there now to send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Ready?
Start on the ground here with Nwangu, and he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. This defense for the Packers, much improved from week one. They were terrific last week in getting their guys their first win of the season.
And the big difference in the ball game, their ability to force turnovers, three of them, in fact. Being able to take the ball away, give it back to their offense, that's something that's emphasized each and every week, and they carried it out.
On the set.
Loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. On play action, they'll throw. Now the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down.
With Sean Gary that time fighting free and getting to the quarterback.
Two plays so far, run and a pass attempt, and both have gone backwards.
Probably not how they drew that up.
Not at all.
Looking for a better play coming up on third.
And not an easy spot here. They'll be in search of 13 yards to try to pick up the first.
Buffalo 18. 19 Lions.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13.
I know at the end of games, coaches always tell us that one or lost a game. But this seems pretty important early, doesn't it? Their ability to pick up that first down on third down, I thought that was key.
18 Cardinal.
After the touchdown on the other side, how will you respond? We talk about that a lot, and they respond. They're looking for Jefferson, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Darnell Savage. And the Packers are going to take possession as they've got it at the 42-yard line.
Partner, when you're playing cover two, this is like a tag team for the safeties. Each of them gets a half-field responsibility. Their job, stay as deep as the deepest receiver in any zone, read the football, and go make a play. In this case, the free safety made the best play, an interception.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway.
60 Bison, 60 Bison.
Excellent field position
19.
Following the INT.
60 Bobcat, 60 Bobcat. Ready?
They'll come out throwing here on first down. His man complete. That's Reed. And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. Give him 13.
13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one.
70 Lions. Trap 60. Trap 60. Ready, ready.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Pass caught. It's Romeo Doubs. Yeah, that's good for a gain of six, and it's second down.
It's a pickup of six. Brings up second and four.
Got it. Ready.
From the gun, they'll try to run it. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. And look at this defense for the Vikings.
Let's
go
now.
This one ranked number five in the NFL against the run.
Dragon 60.
Get their pass defense in line. This
70 Ranger.
Really,
70
really
Ranger.
And remember the conversation with the defensive
Cup 19.
Coordinator.
Cup 19.
He wants to push the passer better. He wants to see the quarterback on the ground. They've got to create some
sacks.
And he said it starts early and often. We'll see if they can get to him. He's got his target. That's complete. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 27-yard line. A nice pickup there. 10 yards.
Someone sharp in this game. I mean, a touchdown pass in the first drive and comes right back.
Here we go, Shaq.
He's flinging it around really well here.
Really nice throw there to pick up the first down. You kind of just feel a laser focus and confidence about him. And I think we saw that this week, didn't we? Talking to him and the coaches, they felt good about his performance coming up.
Yeah, I was really impressed with that last practice we saw when they went through two-minute drill, when they went through all the different situations. Ball hardly hit the ground, and I thought, yeah, he might be locked
Let's
in
go.
For this one.
From the 24 now, here's second down at seven.
Hot, hot.
Throw right side, hauled in by Doubs. And he's down inside the five at the four before he's out of bounds. A good pickup there, 21 yards. Had the offense humming on the first drive. Not much has changed here on drive number two.
No, and I think a lot of the times confidence just really kicks in for a team. They may have been confident going into the game, but once you prove it on a drive, it's hard to get out of that mindset, isn't it? And look, let's face it. We can always lock in on the skill position, guys.
Those
big fellas up front, they're really making this offense go early in the game.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Good first step there defensively, but they're still knocking on the doorstep, so maybe another run here?
I think so. One of my favorite coaches used to say, son, if you could darn near lay down near the end zone and get in, give me my best power running play with my best back right now.
Back goal 80. Say it.
And they'll put a receiver in motion left.
No streak.
In motion right, Doubs.
Ready.
They'll try to run this one in. They follow up the first down 1-yard run with a minimal gain of two.
He did get a taste the previous week. He got into the end zone, tried his best to get there in
come
this
on,
game.
Come on, come on.
So far, he's been denied.
Can this Vikings D hold up one more time? Third and goal.
60 Maverick. 60 Maverick. Ready.
They'll set up a throw. Touchdown, Packers! Romeo Doubs, second touchdown on the season. And the Packers are off to a 13-0 first quarter lead.
Anders Carlson,
his first career touchdown pass, and, you know, it's cliche to say, but he's probably been envisioning this since he was a little kid. That's a cool moment.
It really is. So enjoy the moment, enjoy the time, celebrate, save the full reflection for later. But make sure you grab someone on the sidelines and say, hey, make sure I get that football, okay?
The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line.
here we go.
Probably be the last play of the quarter.
Check, check. Ready, ready.
First play's a run with Nwangu. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Ready?
So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Get up.
They'll go right back to the Nwangu. He'll take it past the 40 to the 41, second down. The Vikings at 0-2 here to begin the season. And listen, they made their share of mistakes in these first two games, CD, but talking with them in the days leading up to this one, doesn't seem like they've lost any confidence.
I would agree with that, and what they told us was that they weren't planning on making any drastic changes. They didn't see the need to shake things up. They were going to continue to plow.
Okay, ready.
They had the right guys on the team and in the locker room, but they do have to start winning some games.
Let's go.
Here's a second and 7. Oh, everything falling apart now. Another one intercepted. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
So rare to see any quarterback toss back-to-back interceptions in the NFL, regardless of status or experience. Whether it's him personally or just the offensive game plan, I think this defense is reading something out there, and they're holding the upper hand.
Check! Go!
Hands it off out of the gun. It'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about 4, second down.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. You could do worse than a 4-yard run on first down.
And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1?
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
Panther 11! Panther 11! 18, Rattler! 18, Rattler!
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. That is caught, and all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. That one good for 24 yards.
Well, things are definitely going right for them here in the first half. Pick a down, any down, even 3rd down, no problem. They get a connection there and pick up a fresh set of downs, continuing to move the ball.
Shut up!
Here's a 1st and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Ready!
And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. The loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down.
And that's what I'd like to see out of this defense, a little fire, a little toughness. It hasn't been the best first half for them, but they did do a nice job there, forcing a loss on that play.
Go!
After the loss, they'll come up 2nd and 13.
Ready.
He's got the hookup with Dobbs. Just a gain of a couple there. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 11.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football.
Ready,
how about the defense
break.
There swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Warrior 70. Nineteen tight. Ready, ready.
He'll look to throw. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And he pulled it. Oh, my goodness. It's no good. He missed it. And this will remain a 2-touchdown game.
Boy, that's 3 points you really expect to have. That's nothing more than a lack of concentration to me, because an NFL kicker,
should make this kick in his Let's go now.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive.
Seven Pirates, seven Pirates.
Start for them offensively. Obviously, two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be starting with it. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
Ready, set.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Check out.
Straight ahead is Kuangu. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Here we go, shot.
38 now.
Cougar 19.
Second and 8.
Let's go.
Another run now for Nwangu. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Let's go.
Here is third down and 4. Back to throw. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Sanders. And he will have a Vikings first down. They needed 5 there on third down. He winds up getting 7.
I'm not sure that that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw on third down. Sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. On the toss, here's Nwangu. Able to slither by. Oh, he breaks a tackle, and he's got an alley. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings. Hey, Nwangu, his third rushing touchdown of the year. And the Vikings are back within a score. Point after, right down the middle. And that'll make our score 14-7. Minnesota's kick team ready, and the Vikings boom it away. And he'll elect not to run with it. And a fair catch on the kickoff will move the ball to the 25.
On the double.
About set to get this drive started.
18,
the Green Bay
right
at the line.
Early 79 on, Broncos.
Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes to a division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated, because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25.
19, Lyon. Mustang 19. Ready?
But just due to the playoff as he'll look to throw. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll get 2 and 3 out of that run, as that is going to take us to the 2-minute warning. He'll get only 3 there, so it leaves him with a 3rd and 7 ahead.
Come on, come on.
7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage.
60 Bobcat, 60 Bobcat. Hey, smash.
They'll bring a receiver in motion right.
Chop 60, chop 60. Ready, ready?
He'll look to throw.
That third down conversion, good for 23.
Good strong throw and catch right
okay,
there.
Okay, great.
So far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Get up.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not
on the ready.
Here's second and 10.
19 Tiger. Check out.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. Pushing his way through. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. 11 yards and a Green Bay Packer first down.
Here we go.
Up on a minute to play in this first half.
Dragon 60. Streak. 70 Timberwolf. 70 Ranger. Let's go.
They'll look to throw here on first down. And his throw's going to be incomplete.
Offense was moving it a little bit, had them back on their heels, but they earned a brief pause by forcing the incompletion. That gives them a quick chance to regroup and try and mount a stand before
ready.
They backed up even further.
Now a second and 10.
Cup 19. 60 Maverick. Panther 11. Eighteen Rattler. Go chap.
Looking to throw. And that's incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's gotta be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
Ready up!
Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. They'll look to throw. Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Rasul Douglas picks it. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him, and what I mean by that is what you said. Third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down.
Ready!
Live for this situation.
I'm not lying. Ready.
On first down, they'll run with Nwangu. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Minnesota. Kenne Nwangu with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Vikings are an extra point away from tying the ball game here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point right down the middle. And that is going to tie our game as we approach halftime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. McKenzie returning it. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
Sack.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. Now the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it. And we'll see these two teams go to the locker.
Ready.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball. Go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. Just what you want
ready,
on a
ready.
First down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and 2.
Ready.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete.
I think he had to hold that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Hawk 70.
Time for the play to develop.
Get up.
This time they stay on the ground. They get 5, and it will go ahead and move the chains. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Viking 18. Check up.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. Room here to run. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number two.
Ready.
Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46.
Panther 60.
And they're out of timeouts, remember, so this is going to have to be a delay. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense
on
backwards a bit. So a little bit of a stiffer challenge now. First and 15 following
Cowboy
the delay
80.
Of game.
Let's go.
Following the penalty, they'll go back to the run game. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. And plenty more to see after the break. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback.
Let's go now.
The Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. This offense ready for the first drive of the third quarter. Well, quarters number one and two entertaining.
60 Eagles, 60 Eagles.
Points put up,
Warriors,
Charles,
70.
All tied on the scoreboard.
And it sets us up for what could be a really fun second half because we've seen both sides score almost at will here in the first half. And now here in the second half, getting the ball first, you've got to think, hey, we can go out and really run our offense the way we did in the first half. But if I'm a defensive player, all I'm thinking is, can I make a play
here
to
we
really
go.
Help my team and break this streak of offense?
On second down, here's Nwangu. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. Now they're going to be dealing with a third and 7. Is that one officially a loss of one?
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness. He's the whole package. And that package just wrapped
Let's
up
go.
The runner for a loss.
Ready?
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He completes this into the hands of Jefferson. And he will have a Vikings first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices,
19
we see
tight,
that after
19
practices
tight.
As well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations.
Ready.
First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Here now is second and 10, again from the 41.
Ready.
Up the middle, Nwangu. And some room to work. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. 111 yards for him on the ground now as he has been terrific here this afternoon.
But when you're able to break a run against a cover two or a two deep zone, safeties are back a little ways. What you're counting on is the guys taking
come on,
care
come
of business
on.
Up front
and it may be climbing to the second level. That offensive lineman or tight end getting up to the second level and able to block the safety in order to create a big run.
Yeah, making those linemen work with a couple blocks. They look good doing it there. Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
Yeah, their back's up against the wall a little bit, and they come through by forcing an incompletion. Now they've got to continue to ratchet up the intensity a couple more times and get off the field.
AC Cardinal, 8-7 Pirates, 7 Pirates. Check out.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, what looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic.
Got it.
They just
got
to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
Go.
Now back to throw. And this one is incomplete.
I think it's safe to say that he's made some questionable decisions out there so far. Forced some throws into tight coverage. He's already been picked off in this game. Fourth down now. But he was fortunate on that one not to have another turnover on his ledger.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And they take a 17-14 lead. Now they don't get a touchdown here in the opening drive of the third quarter, but I think maybe you still say mission accomplished as they come away with the lead.
No, absolutely. You keep the pressure on, right? You go downfield, get some points up on the board, and hope that you've motivated your defense to take the field and hold that lead.
Ready!
About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense.
18,
and they find themselves down
79 Broncos
following the field goal a moment ago.
And I think even though they trail in the game now, I would consider that a win for their defense, and that's probably
60 Bison, 60 Bison. Buffalo 18.
You guys now get back out there and get us the lead back.
19 Lions.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. He's going to launch this deep for Watson. Oh, the turnover fest continues. Here's another interception. Andrew Booth picks it off. And the Vikings are going to get it back here just past the 35. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted. But they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like. Well, I think after that run, the defense is getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit.
Mustang 19.
They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them?
60 Bobcat! 60
Bobcat! And do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Ready?
Second and 4. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
And when you've thrown as many interceptions as he has in this one, you definitely start getting a little hesitant to throw the ball out wide because that's prime pick six territory. That time, he made sure the only guy who was going to catch it was sitting in the third row.
He's going to get that to his running back out of the backfield. And he will have a Vikings first down as he'll be marked down a yard or two past the marker following a gain of 6.
Okay, ready.
Defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing
right
playing
there,
against
right
a
there.
Good quarterback ready. Like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle.
Dude.
It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards
check
the quarterback
check
and still
Bobcat.
Try and cover downfield.
Now a give running right, Nwangu. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line.
Hustle!
And quickly, they get to the line.
Chop 60! Chop 60! Check out!
He'll drop to throw. Going underneath, he's got Hockenson. And he will have a Vikings first down. And he was able to get it by plenty. A gain of 8 on 3rd and 3.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings
let's
do
go
pay
now.
Off, don't they? What do the guys in locker
room call
him? Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him old reliable.
Yeah, go. That means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up 2nd down.
Here we go. Shot. Run, hunt.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he's got this to Jefferson. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. That one good for 37 yards.
A team's practiced their plays during the week. They're hoping that it's going to pay off on game
Let's
day.
Go.
So it sure has to feel good for them when they hit them during
Panther
a game.
Streak.
And they
Panther
hit that
streak.
One there for big yardage.
Hand off here to Nwangu. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Only a yard that time. Second and goal.
Deputy. Ready.
They'll look to run with Nwangu. Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Through a couple of plays, this Green Bay defense is held strong. Now it's third and goal.
Ready.
They'll try and sneak it here. And he'll get in. He's over for the touchdown. What a great play there. Scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And they are able to add on to their advantage. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it. Keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
The extra point splits the uprights, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. But no run back here. Fair catch, and this will come out to the 25.
Come on, come on.
Packer offense ready to get their next
Dragon
drive
60.
Underway. So now, Charles, this drive, maybe a touch
70
more
Ranger,
important, trying to erase the
Lions.
Memory of that interception
Come 19, come 19.
Yeah, and everyone goes through this because ready, even ready? The best in the game, you're going to have games where it just doesn't go right for you, an interception's result. So, frankly, to me, it's all about how you respond, not just the types of plays that you call, but how you carry yourself, how you show your team that you're still with it, and how you continue to lead.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front buying that time?
Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. And a great job there to read that one defensively. They strung him out, would not allow him to cut up field.
Here we go, here we go.
Six now.
60 Maverick, 60 Maverick. Check up.
They're going to look to throw. Look to the side, and he's got a man. That's Reed. So give him 5.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. Franco Leedy.
With a third and just a yard. And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. This is the National Football League on EA Sports.
Ready?
The Packers on third down. They've hit on 6 of their 8 tries. Very good. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation.
Panther 11! Panther 11! Go!
Back to throw again. And that is incomplete.
I think the defenders have to feel pretty good, even though the ball was tipped in the air and could have become a big play for the offense. They actually won one because the guy flinging it today, he's having quite the performance. A couple of touchdown passes, almost threw his first interception, but he's throwing it so well that I think Lady Luck was on his side.
They're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down.
18 Rattler, 18 Rattler.
Last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
Warriors 70. 19 tight, 19 tight.
Got to try it here. He's back to throw. Bears have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. So how about that for an answer? They get the touchdown there, and it's back to a one-score game here in the fourth.
And that's what these guys have done all game long, because they've scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game. And by now, we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense, because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
Carlson's extra point up and good. And now things get a bit more interesting here in this fourth quarter. So after the made field goal, here's Carlson to send it away. And a couple yards deep, he'll go to a knee. He won't return it. And they'll take it out to the 25.
Ready, ready!
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 131 yards rushing for him now, as he has been tremendous all day long.
Ready,
so
break!
Here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Rig it! Ready!
Give left side here for Nwangu. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. All right, so they got that one, Charles, against the center.
And let's remember how difficult it is for the center, because remember, he's got to snap the ball to put the play in motion, and sometimes you got that big guy on your nose. You got sometimes where he's coming at you at an angle. It's a difficult job for him to snap the ball and then execute his block.
On first down, nothing opening up really on the running play. Give him maybe a yard, and it'll be second down. This defense starting to buckle down when they need to, and right now they're winning this fourth quarter, losing the game, but they're winning in the fourth quarter.
And what a fine line it is about what they're trying to get done, because they're down, so they obviously need the football, need a score, but they can't be so aggressive as to give up their edge, their gaps, and have the offense hit them with a big play.
Seven Pirates! 18, Pioneer! Ready, ready?
Back to throw here. Going underneath, he's got Hockenson. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football.
Let's go now.
That's really good for the game of football.
79 Broncos.
Great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
We're going back to the same well. It's Hockenson again. And this is going to result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 43. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
And that certainly appears to be a critical conversion right there, because not only do they keep the drive going, they take valuable time off the clock.
Here we
as
go,
well.
Check.
They have to feel really good about check, that
Panther.
Last completion.
Check, go.
Now a give running left is Nwangu. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Let's go.
On the give is Nwangu. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
Well, that's not a run that's going to make any of the highlight tapes, but they've been moving it well all game on the ground. This is another one that keeps them moving forward.
Ready, set.
The line to gain is the 33 on third down.
Cougar 19.
They'll run with Nwangu. And he's going to come up a few yards short of the first.
Let's go. 19, target. Buffalo 18.
Here and go for it. This
19, Lion.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Vikings unable to convert here on fourth. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop. About set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. A big opportunity.
Mustang 19.
With three or take the lead with a touchdown.
60 Bobcat. 60 Bobcat.
With that pivotal fourth down stop. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. Throw left side complete. Three. They'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first.
Chop 60. Chop 60. Dragon 60. Seventy Ranger. Ready?
They'll look to throw now on first down. Rush coming and he's taken down.
Set, Temple, set. Let's go. Hawk 70. Hawk 70. Viking 18. Cup 19. Rig alert. 60 Maverick. Ready.
They'll set up to throw. He's going to launch this deep for Watson. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
I know conventional wisdom says, hey, don't get it all back in one play. But sometimes you go ahead and try to. They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
Come on.
Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long.
Panther 11. 18 Rattler. Warrior 70. 19 tight. Ready.
They'll look to throw here. On a huge mistake late, it's intercepted. And the Vikings will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned.
Here we go.
An interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been
Bronco switch.
Quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early? Learned from them and became great later.
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Gotta figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just gonna be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Panther 60. Seven Pirates. Check out.
Second and 11. They'll check that down to Nwangu out of the backfield. Looked like a pretty good safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progression, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down.
Cowboy 80.
In the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice safe throw and a good one.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. This is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here.
Go!
Here's Nwangu. And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down to the 42-yard line. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left.
Ready.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Nwangu, and for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Shut up!
Take four.
Eagles. 60 Eagles. 18 Cardinal. 18 Cardinal.
That one looks like he'll throw here. That'll be complete to the running back, Nwangu. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Ready?
Dallas Nwangu. And this is not going to be enough. Was in search of 2 yards and only got halfway there. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal.
Let's go now.
I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
Sixty Bison. Ready.
On fourth down, they'll try and run for it. And he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. He only needed a yard, but he couldn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. And the Packers D comes up with a big stop.
Here we go, Shaq.
Come up. First and 10 here.
18, Pioneer. Ready, right?
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. The way he's throwing the football today, almost a surprise when he doesn't complete a pass like happened there, but he needs a few more to get his guys downfield.
Well, the way he's thrown it leads him to believe that he's going to get those completions, and that means the guys going out for passes, they'll run even harder.
79 Broncos.
Show partner. This was a close game for a long time. Close at half, close down the stretch. Home team finds a way to get it done, a narrow victory.
Yeah, they finished with a flourish, didn't they? Because there were times where each side looked